Hello, my dear friends. Myself, Bhagwan Pandekar. I am a maths teacher and career counselor. I will teach you the subject mathematics part 2, that is geometry. So today we are going to learn the summary of lesson number 3, triangles. If you like to see many more videos like this, so please like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel. Keep watching, keep learning. So, without wasting any time, let us start this video. Summary 2. Lesson number 3, triangles. In this lesson, there are some subtopics. First is theorem of an isosceles triangles. Second, property of 30 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree angle triangle. Third, median of a triangle. Fourth, property of median on hypotenuse of a right angle triangle. Fifth, perpendicular bisector theorem. Sixth, angle bisector theorem. Seventh, similar triangle. And eighth is project. So these are the some subtopics in this chapter. Summary, isosceles triangle theorem. In this theorem, if two sides of a triangle are congruent, then the angles opposite to them are congruent. Observing this figure, we can write given information. In triangle ABC, side AB congruent side AC. To prove triangle ABC congruent triangle ACB. Construction. Draw the bisector of angle BAC which intersect side BC at point D. Proof. In triangle ABD and triangle ACD, segment AB congruent segment AC. This is given information. Angle BAD congruent angle CAD. Reason is construction. Segment AD congruent segment AD. Reason is common side. Therefore, triangle ABD congruent triangle ACD. Reason is SAS test. Therefore, angle BAD congruent angle ACD. Reason is congruence angle of congruence triangle. Therefore, angle ABC congruent angle ACB. Reason is we know that the B dash D dash C, that is BDC, are in linear point. Corollary, if all sides of a triangle are congruent, then its all angles are congruent. Write the proof of this corollary. This is your self-study. Converse of isosceles triangle theorem. In this theorem, if two angles of a triangle are congruent, then the sides opposite to them are congruent. Observing this figure, we can write the given information. In triangle PQR, angle PQR congruent angle PRQ. To prove side PQ congruent side PR. Construction. Draw the bisector of angle P intersect side QR at point M as shown in the figure. Proof. In triangle PQM and triangle PRM. Angle PQM congruent angle PRM. This is given information. Angle QPM congruent angle PRM. Reason is construction. Segment PM congruent segment PM. That is common side. Therefore, triangle PQM congruent triangle PRM. Reason is SAA test. Therefore, segment PQ congruent segment PR. Reason is congruence side of congruent triangle. Corollary, if three angles of a triangle are congruent, then its three sides also congruent. Write the proof of this corollary yourself. This is your homework. Property of 30 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree triangle. In this theorem, the equatangle of a right angle triangle have measures 30 degree and 60 degree. Then the length of the side opposite to 30 degree angle is the half of the length of the hypotenuse. Observing this figure, we can write given information in triangle ABC, angle B is equal to 90 degree, angle C is equal to 30 degree, and angle A is equal to 60 degree. To prove, AB is equal to 1 upon 2 into AC. Construction. Take a point D on the extended segment AB and such that AB is equal to BD. So, draw the segment DC. In this figure, we can write proof. In triangle ABC and triangle DBC, segment AB congruent segment DB. Reason is construction. Angle ABC congruent angle DBC. Reason is each measures 90 degree. Segment BC congruent segment BC. Reason is common side. So therefore, triangle ABC congruent triangle DBC. So reason is S A S test. Therefore, angle BAC congruent angle BDC. Reason is congruent angle of congruence triangle. In triangle ABC, angle BAC is equal to 60 degree. Therefore, angle BAC is equal to 60 degree. We know that sum of the angles of triangle ADC is equal to 180 degree. In triangle ADC is an equilateral triangle. So therefore, AC is equal to AD is equal to DC. Reason is corollary of corners of isosceles triangle theorem. But AB is equal to 1 upon 2 into AD. Reason is construction. Therefore, AB is equal to 1 upon 2 into AC. We know that AD is equal to AC. So therefore, hence the proof. Property of 30 degree, 60 degree, 90 degree triangle. Activity first. In this theorem, if the acute angle of right angle triangle have measures 30 degree and 60 degree, then the length of the side opposite to 60 degree angle is root 3 upon 2 into hypotenuse. We have drawn the figure here. Observing this figure and given information, we can write proof. In the above theorem, we have proved AB is equal to 1 upon 2 into AC. So therefore, AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square by using the Pythagoras theorem. Therefore, AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square. So reason is Pythagoras theorem. So therefore, 1 upon 4 into AC square plus BC square is equal to AC square. Therefore, BC square is equal to AC square minus 1 upon 4 into AC square. So here, therefore, BC square is equal to 3 upon 4 into AC square. Therefore, BC is equal to root 3 upon 2 into AC. Hence the proof.
Property of 45 degree, 90 degree triangle, activity second. In this theorem, we measures of angles of a triangle are 45 degree, 90 degree. Then the length of each side containing the right angle is 1 upon root 2 into hypotenuse. We can draw the figure in this way. From the figure and given information, we can write proof. In triangle ABC, angle B is equal to 90 degree and angle A is equal to angle C is equal to 45 degree. So therefore, we can write BC is equal to AB. Therefore, AB square plus BC square is equal to AC square by using the Pythagoras theorem. Therefore, AB square plus AB square is equal to AC square. Here putting the BC's value is AB since BC is equal to AB. Therefore, we can write 2AB square is equal to AC square. So therefore, AB square is equal to AC square upon 2. Taking a square root on both sides, we can write AB is equal to 1 upon root 2 into AC. Hence the proof. Median of a triangle. The segment joining a vertex and midpoint of the side opposite to it is called a median of the triangle. We can write the figure. We can draw the figure here. Observing this figure, we can write in figure point D is the midpoint of the side BC. Therefore, segment AD is a median of triangle ABC. Property of median drawn on the hypotenuse of right triangle. In this theorem, in a right angle triangle, The length of the median of the hypotenuse is the half length of the hypotenuse. We can draw the figure in this way. From this figure and given information, we can write given information in triangle ABC, angle B is equal to 90 degree. Segment BD is the median. To prove, BD is equal to 1 upon 2 into AC. Construction, take a point E on the ray BD such that B dash D dash E and length BD is equal to length D. Draw segment EC. In this way, draw the segment EC in this figure. You can write proof. Main steps are given. Write the steps in between and complete the proof. Triangle ADB congruent triangle CDE. Reason is by the SAS test. Line AB parallel line AC. Reason is by the test of alternate angle. Therefore, triangle ABC congruent triangle ECB. Reason is by SAS test. Therefore, BD is equal to 1 upon 2 into AC. Hence the proof. Perpendicular bisector theorem. Part 1st. Every point on the perpendicular bisector of a segment is equidistant from the end point of the segment. You can draw the figure in this way. You can write, observing this figure and given information, we can write line L is the perpendicular bisector of segment AB at point M. Point P is any point on the line L. To prove, PA is equal to PB. Construction, draw a segment AP and segment BP. Proof, in triangle PMA and triangle PMB, segment PM congruent segment PM. Reason is common side. Angle PMA congruent angle PMB. Reason is each is a right angle. Segment AM congruent segment BM. Reason is given. Therefore, triangle PMA congruent triangle PMB. Reason is SAS test. Therefore, we can write segment PA congruent segment PB. So, reason is congruent side of congruent triangle. Therefore, length PA is equal to length PB. Hence the proof. Hence, every point on the perpendicular bisector of a segment is equidistant from the end point of the segment. Perpendicular bisector theorem, part 2. Any point equidistant from the end point of a segment lies on the perpendicular bisector of segment. You can draw the figure in this way. From this, observing this figure and given information, we can write given data. Point P is any point equidistant from the end point of segment AB. That is PA is equal to PB. To prove, point P is on the perpendicular bisector of segment AB. Construction, take midpoint M of segment AB and draw the line PM. Proof, in triangle PAM and triangle PBM. Segment PA congruent segment PB. Reason is given information. Segment AM congruent segment BM. Reason is given information. Segment PM congruent segment PM. Reason is common side. Therefore, triangle PAM congruent triangle PBM. Reason is side test. Therefore, angle PMA congruent angle PMB congruent angle of congruent triangle. But angle PMA plus angle PMB is equal to 180 degree. Therefore, angle PMA plus angle PMB is equal to 180 degree. In bracket, since angle PMA is equal to angle PMB. Therefore, 2 angle PMA is equal to 180 degree. So, therefore, angle PMA is equal to 90 degree. Segment PM perpendicular segment AB. But point M is the midpoint of the segment AB. Construction, that is equation 2. Therefore, line PM is a perpendicular bisector of segment AB. So point P is on the perpendicular bisector of segment AB. Hence the proof. Angle bisector theorem. Part first. Every point on the bisector of an angle is equidistant from the side of the angle. We can draw the figure in this way. From this figure and given information, we can write given ray QS is a bisector of angle PQR. Point A is any point on ray QS. Segment AB perpendicular ray QP. Segment AC perpendicular ray QR. To prove, segment AB congruent segment AC. Proof: in triangle ABQ and triangle ACQ, segment OA congruent segment OA. Region is common side. Angle ABQ congruent angle ACQ. Each measures 90 degree. Angle AQB congruent angle AQC. Region is ray QA bisector angle PQR. Therefore, triangle ABQ congruence triangle AQC. Region is side angle angle test. Therefore, segment AB congruent segment AC. Region is congruent angle of congruent triangle. Hence the proof. Angle bisector theorem part 2. Any point equidistant from the side of an angle is on the bisector of the angle. We can draw the figure in this way. Observing this figure and given information, we can write A is a point in the interior of angle PQR. Segment AC perpendicular ray QR. Segment AB perpendicular ray QP. And AB is equal to AC. To prove, ray QA is a bisector of angle PQR. That is, angle BQA is equal to angle CQA. Proof: in triangle ABQ and triangle ACQ, angle ABQ is equal to angle ACQ is equal to 90 degree. Reason is given information. Hypotenuse AQ congruent hypotenuse AQ, that is common side. Side AB congruent side AC, that is a given information. So therefore, triangle ABQ congruent triangle AQC by the hypotenuse side test. Therefore, angle BQA is equal to angle CQA. Reason is congruent angle of congruent triangle. Therefore, ray QA is the bisector of angle PQR. Properties of inequalities of sides and angles of a triangle. Theorem: if two sides of a triangle are unequal, then the angle opposite to the greater side is greater than the angle opposite to the smaller side. We can draw the figure in this way. From this figure and given information, we can write given in triangle XYZ, side XZ is greater than side XY. To prove, angle XYZ is greater than angle XZY. Construction: take point P on the side XZ such that XY is equal to XP. Draw segment YP. Proof: in triangle XYP, XY is equal to XP. Reason is construction. Angle XYP is equal to angle XPY. Isosceles triangle theorem, equation first. Angle XPY is an exterior angle of triangle YPZ. Therefore, angle XPY is greater than angle PZY. Reason is exterior angle theorem. Therefore, angle XYP is greater than angle PZY from equation first. Therefore, angle XYP plus angle PYZ is greater than angle PZY. Reason is if A is greater than B and C is greater than 0, then A plus C is greater than B. Therefore, angle XYZ is greater than angle PZY, that is angle XYZ is greater than angle XZY. Hence the proof. Properties of inequalities of sides and angles of a triangle theorem. If two angles of a triangle are unequal, then the side opposite to the greater the angle is greater than the side opposite to the smaller angle. You can draw the figure in this way. Observing this figure, we can write given information. In triangle ABC, angle B is greater than angle C. To prove, AC is greater than AB. Proof: there are only three possibilities regarding the length of the side AB and side AC of the triangle ABC. Proof: first, AC is less than AB. Second, AC is equal to AB. Third, AC is greater than AB. Let first prove. Let us assume that AC is less than AB. If two sides of a triangle are unequal, then the angle opposite to the greater side is greater. So therefore, angle C is greater than angle B. But angle C is less than angle B. Here the given information. This creates a contradiction. So therefore, AC is less than AB is wrong. Second proof. If AC is equal to AB, then angle B is equal to angle C. But angle B is greater than angle C. Here the given information. So therefore, AC is equal to AB is wrong. Therefore, AC is greater than AB is the only remaining possibilities. Therefore, AC is greater than AB. Hence the proof. Next theorem. The sum of any two sides of a triangle is greater than the third side. We can draw this figure in this way. From this figure and given information, we can write triangle ABC is any triangle. To prove, AB plus AC is greater than BC, AB plus BC is greater than AC, AC plus BC is greater than AB. Construction: take a point D on ray BA such that AD is equal to AC. Proof: in triangle ACD, AC is equal to AD. Reason is construction. Proof: angle ACD is equal to angle ADC. So reason is congruent angle of the congruent triangle. Therefore, angle ACD plus angle ACB is greater than angle ADC. Therefore, angle BCD is greater than angle ADC. So therefore, side BD is greater than side BC. Reason is the side opposite to greater angle is greater. So therefore, BA plus AD is greater than BC since BD is equal to BA plus AD. Therefore, BA plus AC is greater than BC since AD is equal to AC. Similarly, we can prove that AB plus BC is greater than AC and BC plus AC greater than AB. Hence the proof. Similar triangles, observe the following figures. Here are the four figures. The pair of figures shown in each part have the same shape, but their sizes are different. It means that they are not congruent. Such like looking figures are called similar figures. Similarity of triangles. In triangle ABC and triangle PQR, first, angle A is equal to angle P, angle B is equal to angle Q, and angle C is equal to angle R. Second, AB upon PQ is equal to BC upon QR is equal to AC upon PR. Then triangle ABC and triangle PQR are called similar triangles. Therefore, triangle ABC and triangle PQR are similar is written as triangle ABC similar triangle PQR. Project for student: prepare a map of road surrounding your school or home up to a distance of about 50 meters. My dear student, thank you for watching this video. Don't forget like, share and subscribe my YouTube channel Bhagwan Pandekar, Career for You and Maths for You. Keep watching, keep learning, stay home, stay safe. Thank you so much.